Eliot is, I think, people love because he's so fluid, like everything, and him having to. Fluid as fuck. It is. Fluid as fuck. Because he's a guy that if I were going to college and I saw him, I'd be like, I need to hang out with that guy because he knows what's going on. He knows everything about everything. Yet, you get thrust into sexy Narnia, basically. You know, and with which should be a thing that you'd think these characters would love. Oh my god, that Fillory's real, they get to go to Fillory. And it's the most oppressive, like, you are so much responsibility, and the kingdom is being choked out. So how is he dealing with all this responsibility?
I think he, at first, you know, when he becomes the High King, he doesn't really realize what he's getting himself into. And he attempts to recreate the life that he had at school, which was, I'm at the top of the heap, I can essentially control my surroundings and live a life of frivolity and debauchery and get away with it. And he's enough of a genius that he doesn't have to study that hard. He's Eliot, for God's sake. So, I think the kingdom really kind of like took him down a few notches, and you know, he was struggling with some addiction, he's in a new land, he doesn't know which end is up, and he's not formally trained in ruling a country of people he knows nothing about. So, yeah, it's a big learning curve for him, and he can't recreate his past, so he's coming to terms with being a real person to other people and acknowledging his own brokenness.